Problem number 4, add or subtract the radical expression. So we have the square root of 75x to the 9th power plus x, the square root of 48x to the 7th power. As you can see, the radicals are not like radicals. So before we can add them, we need to see if we can individually simplify them to end up with like terms. Let's start with the first term and let's see if we can separate this into its perfect square root and its non-perfect square root. So 75 has two factors, which would be 25, the perfect square root, and times 3. And then when we have variables with exponents, because this has index 2, the exponent needs to be divisible by 2. So 9 is not divisible by 2, but I could take out 1x from x to the 9th power, and I'm left with x to the 8th power, which now is divisible by 2. So this would be its perfect part. Now let's see if we can do the same thing with the second term. And I already have an x outside, and then I'm going to split the 48x to the 7 into its perfect and non-perfect part. So 48 has two factors, where one of them is a perfect square root, which is 16, and 16 times 3 in this case. And then again, when you have a variable raised to an exponent, because this is index 2, the exponent needs to be divisible by 2. This is an odd number, so it's not, but I could take out 1, and I'm left with x to the 6, which now is divisible by 2. Taking the square roots of its perfect part, we get 5. For the 25, the square root of 25 is 5, and then x to the 8th power, now you have to divide by the index, in this case 2, so 8 divided by 2, we get x to the 4, and we are left with its non-perfect part, 3x. Then we had a plus sign, we have an x outside, so I'm going to put it here, and then taking the square root of its perfect part, so the square root of 16 is 4, and the square root of x to the 6, again, we divide by the index. 6 divided by 2 is 3. And we are left with 3x under the root, which is its non-perfect part. Now let me simplify that. I had an x outside, and I got an x to the 3rd power once I took out my perfect square root. I can multiply these two together. This has an imaginary exponent of 1, so when I multiply them together, I basically add their exponents, and I get x to the 4th power. So let me bring down the first part. And then, like I said, we combine them. Now we got x to the 4th power with the square root of 3x. Now we have like radicals. Both of them have outside x to the 4th power, and right here, and both of them have a radical of 3x. So these are like radicals now, and we can add their coefficients. 5 plus 4 is 9, and x 4 with a radical of 3x. As you notice, the x fourth and the 3x stay the same. Only their coefficients got added together. So 9x to the 4th power and the square root of 3x is the final answer for this problem.